Some countries really excel at producing elite athletes in specific sports. Sprinters from Jamaica, hockey players from Canada, judo grapplers from Japan, long distance runners from Kenya, Aussie rules football players from Australia. But since our last video was on the hurdles, I thought it would be interesting to see which country produces the best hurdlers. There are, of course, a few different criteria we could use, so we'll look at a number of things and see who comes out on top. The winning country will surprise you, but I'll tell you this much. It's not the USA. In our last video, we showed how the heights of the men's high hurdles and the distance between hurdles creates a narrow range of tall athletes that can actually compete in the event. A link to the video is in the description. In that video, we found that about 90% of elite male hurdlers have heights between 6 feet and 6 feet 4 inches, or 183 to 193 centimeters. This makes it difficult, or more difficult, for some countries to compete in the hurdles. This will come into play as we consider which country produces the best hurdlers. Hurdles is also a rich kid's sport, meaning that poor countries have a harder time competing in the hurdles, even if the country has a lot of fast athletes. Consider Nigeria, a populous poor country. It has 6 of the fastest 100 people in the world right now, but not one person in the top 100 of the high hurdles in the world. It's a lot easier in a poor country to train to run fast, but not so easy to learn how to hurdle fast. That's one reason why the 100 meter dash is more competitive than the 110 meter hurdles, because it's harder for a poor country to compete in the hurdles. African nations, which have 19 of the fastest 100 people in the world, only have 5 of the top 100 hurdlers in the world. So let's dive in. What country is best at producing elite hurdlers? Let's start by looking at who has the most hurdlers in the top 100 in the world and the top 300 in the world. There's a strong case for the USA if we're only using this metric. They produce more top hurdlers than any other country, with 18 of the top 100 hurdlers and 77 in the top 300. They've also dominated this event in the Olympics. However, the US is like the rich spoiled kid that gets everything they want. They have a large, diverse population with plenty of tall, fast athletes. They have a sports-crazed culture and plenty of money and resources to help train athletes. Almost every high school in the US has a track and hurdles. It'd be surprising if we didn't dominate in the hurdles when comparing by sheer numbers. But I don't want to crown our winner just off of sheer numbers. I want to find the country that excels without all the benefits that the US has and really beats the odds. So let's consider some other factors and take a closer look at some other countries that don't have everything going for them. The working class kid that still puts the rich spoiled kids in their place. We will start with a list of potentially top countries and narrow it down with a few other pieces of criteria to see who comes out on top. Given this list, who do you think is going to come out on top? You can put that in your comments below. First, let's establish a minimum. To be the best country at producing hurdlers, they should have at least 2 hurdlers in the top 100 and 4 in the top 300. If a country doesn't meet this minimal criteria, it'd be hard to say that they are the best. This does cut out the Bahamas, with only 1 hurdler in the top 100 and 4 in the top 300. But with a measly population of just 400,000, that is pretty remarkable. They definitely deserve an honorable mention. After using this criteria, here's who we have left. Australia, Brazil, China, Spain, France, Great Britain, Germany, Jamaica, Japan, Poland, Russia, Switzerland, and the USA. The next criteria we will use is that the countries need to do well in their hurdles compared to the speed they have in their country. If the country has a lot of speedsters, but not many elite hurdlers, they aren't reaching their potential. We lose these 4 countries using this criteria. Great Britain, for example, has 16 of the top 300 sprinters, but only 7 of the top 300 hurdlers. Jamaica drops from 28 top 300 sprinters to only 16 hurdlers. While this is still extraordinarily high for such a small country, the large drop from 28 to 16 can be interpreted as a lack of production of hurdlers given all the speed in that country. It is really hard to drop Jamaica, especially since Jamaica took 2 medals in the high hurdles in the last Olympics. There is a strong argument that because of their small size of just 2.8 million people, they should be number 1. I'm going to keep them in my top 3 for now, with the USA, but the big drop off from the sprinters to hurdlers is a strike against them. There are a few countries that actually stand out by this criteria. France has only 9 of the elite sprinters, but 19 of the elite hurdlers, which shows an overproduction of hurdlers for the speed in the country. Russia and China, similarly, more than double their sprinters to hurdlers, so these countries are doing very well. Let's move on to our next piece of criteria, height. It is easier to produce hurdlers if you have a lot of tall people in your country. I calculated the percent of the male population taller than 6 feet, or 183 centimeters, for for each of the remaining countries using this website. Some of these countries are at a huge disadvantage. Look at China and Japan. They just don't have many tall people. Switzerland, on the other hand, has a very high percentage of tall people. But percentages is not the whole story. Country size is also important. Sure, China has a small percentage of people that are over 6 feet, but they still have well over a billion people, and so number-wise, they still have a lot of tall people. Using this info, I tried to estimate the number of tall males each country has to pull from. I multiplied the population of the country by the percentage of tall males and divided by 2. This comes my estimate of millions of tall males in the country. You can see why the US might dominate. They have more tall male people than all of China, even though China has more than 4 times as many people than the US. And that's calling someone that measures 6 feet tall, quote unquote, tall. Japan, on the other hand, doesn't even have a million tall males in their entire country. So what do we do with this information? Let's look at how many elite hurdlers each country produces, accounting for the number of tall males. We will divide the number of elite hurdlers by the number of tall males in that country. And here are the results. These numbers are the number of elite hurdlers we expect each country to produce per million tall males. From these numbers, we see that there is one country that is dominating the others, Japan. By this metric, the US is pretty run-of-the-mill, getting beat by Switzerland, Poland, France, and Spain. But Japan is off the charts. I doubt many of you would have put Japan at the top of the list at the beginning of this video. I bet you wouldn't have even had it in the top 3. But Japan, that country of small samurai, produced 10% of all elite hurdlers in the world, second only to the US. And they do it with hurdlers that all seem to be 6 feet or less. Here's an image from the finals of the Japanese National Championships. We could track down heights of a few of these individuals. These two are both about 5'9", or 179 centimeters. These others are all darn close to 6 feet, or 183 centimeters. None of these are taller than the two shortest hurdlers in the Olympic finals. Maybe it isn't surprising that Japan produces about as many elite sprinters as Jamaica, 28 to 27, but it is surprising that it can produce twice as many hurdlers as Jamaica, 30 to 16, and do it with males of such short stature. That is truly remarkable and arguably worth the claim that they are the best country at producing world-class hurdlers. That rounds out my top 3 with Japan for doing it with short athletes, the US for the sheer numbers, and Jamaica for doing it with such few people. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.